Before I start a painting, I always lay down a few sheets of go-between freezer paper. Then, any off-runnings, I keep these as skins and I make jewellery out of them. To do this, you'll need to purchase some glass cabochons and bezels. The cabochons and bezels come in a set of 10 and they cost around about $8.50 on eBay complete. You can get them in bronze or silver, whatever suits the artwork you have. Then you can get smaller ones and you can make earrings, which also look really cute. 5 sets of earrings. You can buy the glass cabochon and the bezels with the earring clips for about $14 on eBay. You'll need some diamond glaze, also available on eBay for approximately $27 for this size, which is 240 mils, but you can get smaller ones for as little as $4. Now you'll also need some E6000 industrial strength clear glue. You can use just this, it's cheaper than the diamond glaze, or you can use a combination of both. The diamond glaze is good for gluing the cabochons onto the artwork. You have to use this one for gluing the finished work onto the bezel. Before I start, I clean the cabochon with a paper towel that has been dipped in Windex, window cleaner. I'll clean all of them. And I wipe down the artwork as well to make sure there's no oil left from the painting. Otherwise the glue won't stick. Then I take the cabochon and I place it over the skin until I find a spot that looks quite attractive. That one looks good. Let's try some on this orangey one. Looks quite interesting. Well, that looks quite lunar. Look at that. That's nice. I think I'm going to use that one. And then for the earrings, if you want it to go with this, you're going to have to find something that matches in colour or pattern. Preferably two similar ones. That's quite good there. How about those two? That looks fine. Okay, then you take your diamond glaze. Don't shake it. Cover the back of the cabochon liberally and then squish it. And move it around until all the bubbles are out. Make sure you don't want any bubbles of air in there. So move it around. And then when it's in the spot that you want it, just make sure it's pressed down firmly and that there are no air bubbles left in. And then do the same for the earring cabochons. Doesn't take a lot of glue. Make sure you've moved all the air bubbles out. And then set that aside for at least 24 hours to cure. Okay, so here's one I've prepared earlier. So these have set nice and hard. Take some little scissors and cut roughly around it. Don't cut more than you have to because there might be another perfect piece there for you. So you cut around nice and close to the glass cabochon. So, and decide how you're going to place it in the bezel first before you apply glue. I quite like that. I'm going to put it in like that. Now wipe again with the cloth with the Windex to make sure you've got all your greasy fingerprints off it. And this is where we use the E6000. And you place a dollop, not too much. It's a bit tacky. And then you place it in the bezel and squish it around until the glue is everywhere. Wipe off any excess with your cloth that has been soaked in Windex. Make sure you press until you can see the glue coming up over the edges. You get the orientation that you most desire. And then leave that for 48 hours at least to dry. And do the same for the earrings. Again, a dollop of the E6000. Make sure you wipe the bezels and the artwork before you glue. Can put the glue directly onto the bezel. Wiggle it around. With the earrings, you probably want to get them to be a mirror image approximately of each other. And there you have it. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned and subscribe.